Ever get stuck thinking about those big cosmic what-ifs?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Well, today we're diving into a real mind-bender. What if, Mercury was at the center of everything, instead of the sun?
Right, we looked at some sources exploring that. A fascinating, kind of wild idea.
Totally wild. So the immediate question is, what does that even look like? You swap the sun for tiny Mercury.
And the first thing you hit is mass. It's the elephant in the room, isn't it?
How big a difference are we talking?
Huge. The sun is roughly 6 million times more massive than Mercury.
6 million, wow.
Yeah, and since gravity depends directly on mass, you know, that changes,
yeah,
well, everything, the whole structure.
Okay, so gravity's the glue. Less mass means less glue, right? Less reef.
Exactly. That brings us to something called the Hill Sphere. Think of it like a planet's personal space, gravitationally speaking.
Its zone of influence.
Precisely. And for Mercury, in our solar system now, dominated by the sun, its hill sphere is actually tiny.
How tiny?
About 175,000 kilometers radius, give or take.
Okay, 175,000 kilometers. But wait, how far is Venus from the sun now?
Venus is way out, over 108 million kilometers. Earth's even further, almost 150 million.
Whoa, so Mercury's little gravity bubble doesn't even come close to reaching them where they are now.
Not even remotely close. So yeah, your first big takeaway, if you just swapped them out.
The planets would just drift away. They wouldn't orbit Mercury at all.
They'd be gone, lost in space. Because Mercury simply doesn't have the gravitational muscle.
Okay, that's a pretty dramatic start. So for a Mercury system to even exist, things would need to be fundamentally different.
Totally different. And think about orbits. Kepler's third law connects orbital speed to the central mass.
Less mass means slower orbits?
Mm-hmm.
Or closer.
To keep similar periods, like a year, planets would need to be way, way closer to low-mass Mercury. Orbits would shrink dramatically.
Like, how much closer? Can you give an example? Let's say Venus again.
Okay, imagine Venus orbiting Mercury, but really close in, let's say, 100,000 kilometers out.
So inside that hill sphere we talked about.
Right. Instead of its current 225-day year around the sun, its year-round Mercury would be about 15 and a half Earth days.
15 days for a whole year. That's insane.
It's incredibly fast. A completely different sense of time, really.
So you'd need to, like, cram all the planets super close to Mercury.
Exactly. The sources we looked at even modeled things like a hypothetical smaller Venus orbiting much nearer Mercury, just to make it work gravitationally.
But squeezing planets together sounds dangerous.
It is. Very dangerous. Mercury's weak gravity wouldn't be strong enough to keep everything stable when planets are that close.
What would happen?
Well, you get much stronger gravitational nudges between the planets. Perturbations with them. Much higher risk of things bumping into each other.
Collisions
or planets getting kicked out of the system entirely. Well, unstable. Probably wouldn't last long.
The cosmic demolition derby. Yikes. Okay, and what about the planets themselves orbiting so close?
Yeah. Tidal forces would be intense that close to Mercury. Planets will almost certainly become tidally locked.
Meaning one side always faces Mercury.
Exactly. One side baked, the other side frozen in permanent darkness. Really extreme temperature differences, not very hospitable.
So summing it up, a Mercury-centered system would be tiny, super fast, planets crammed together, probably tidally locked.
And incredibly unstable. Precarious, really. Makes you appreciate our sun, doesn't it?
It really does. Our system seems so calm and stable in comparison. And what about the big guys? Jupiter, Saturn.
Oh, chance. Mercury's hill sphere, even on its own without the sun, just isn't big enough to hold on to giant planets that far out. They wouldn't be part of the system.
So just a small, compact cluster of inner worlds, if anything.
Pretty much. It's a fundamentally different beast than what we know.
It really hammers home how crucial the sun's mass is. Swapping it isn't a small change. It creates something almost unrecognizable and probably very fleeting.
Absolutely. The scale is just completely different.
Okay, so here's something to mull over. If somewhere out there, a tiny, super-fast system like this Mercury one actually exists, what kind of weird evolutionary path could life possibly take in such a frantic environment, assuming it could even start?
That's a great question to ponder. It really makes you think.
Definitely food for thought. Well, thanks for diving deep into this cosmic what-if with us today.